Brother, somewhere out there there's a riddle you'd enjoy, and I'm going to find it.
Do not.
Once spoken, instantly broken. What am I?
Silence.
Correct!
I was not answering the riddle.
Ah.
You're back.
We have news of your son.
Oh, please, tell me.
He died trying to find the other treasure. He didn't know you were doing the same.
No. This is my fault.
He disobeyed your wishes.
Yes, because that is what sons do. I should have brought him with me. We'd be alive and rich beyond all reason.
Don't blame yourself.
Nevertheless, thank you.
I'm glad we did this, Kratos.
Yes.
And I'm sure Atreus will be as well.
Yes.
Just curious, brother. Why don't you like riddles?
They are frivolous.
They encourage lateral thinking. Listen, there are... doors before you. One can contain a pit of spikes, one a dragon, and one a pair of lions that haven't been fed in weeks. Which door do you open?
The first. Pit of spikes is easily avoided.
Ah, you should pick the third, because lions that haven't been fed in weeks would be dead! Eh?
I like this riddle.
Thank you.
Whatever you need, I'll create. And now, Freya? What can I make for you? Anything for Freya? No need to think. I'll disinfect my tools. If you change your mind... fancy a riddle?
If you fancy a boot.
Know what? We'll finish this later.
Alfheim, what's there?
There's work to be done. We found a Hofgufer out in the Barrens, m'lady. In terrible pain. We freed it, but there's another intern somewhere beneath the Forbidden Sands.
A Hofgufer? I haven't seen one since I was a child.
And what else? There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Lead the way.
Make the spear? Wait, no. Brock has to be the one to tell me what happened. I'm just gonna pretend I was never here.
Freya, I've always wondered. Why was Freyr so revered here so quickly upon his first arrival?
Well, to begin with, it wasn't his first arrival. Very few know this, but Freyr was one of the earliest visitors to Alfheim. Back in the dawn of realm travel.
Oh? But before my time. You tell.
We believed for a long time that all the giants had died in the Flood. Until one of them appeared in Vanaheim. Her name was Gerd. And she came offering to teach us the secrets of traveling between realms using Bifrost Light. Freyr became immediate. Infatuated with her. He always yearned to wander, and along came someone who could truly show him how. So, wander they did, exploring the world tree from root to branch. But one day, it came time for Gerd to wander away. Freyr was heartbroken, and resolved himself to perform some great feat to win her back. He set his aim on the grandest of gestures. He intended to be the first to find the...
Hold. Prepare for a fight. The Hiltgrace battle that grave will provide.
From under the cruel, we dagger the core and fit them with the rifle.
You can't draw!
I felt that one, brother!
That's a pretty nice axe.
Come on, Kaido, get him!
The Hiltgrace battle that grave will provide.
From under the cruel, dagger the cold, and bitter the rifle.
Get up, brother!
Not!
Freya, returning to the story of your brother, you said he made it his mission to find the source of Bifrost Light.
He did indeed.
Hold. Let us search this area.
Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that path, which must mean...
Another Hafgufar!
Mekki! I remember when Freya and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hafgufa. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave! Appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet, once this Hafgufa is free. This architecture... it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive matter as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
Mm-hmm.
effect. Perhaps a different arrow. This kind of hive material is sensitive to sound. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by hive matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hafgifer for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Denser. Well, there you go. Enemy behind you.
Behind you, brother! the last.
Light elves don't often travel underneath the barons, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim, or so it appears.
Bigthyr did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree.
That hive doesn't like sound, remember?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Freeing these half-goofers will allow them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate.
I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once freed.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hakufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their light to their children.
And without light, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance, I know what choice I would take. Good. Almost there.
The surface, then.
Find you! Incoming!
Oh.
pipe.
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
Fate of these creatures. It reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... Well, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is the better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
Well, at least it's a relatable story.
Go! Go!
It appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim. Yet again.
The Alpha!
Time to end this storm.
Comfort. Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know there is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they.
Get misty. It's beautiful.
Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens? In my travels, I heard of a great battle in your homeland, at a place called the Gates of Fire.
The Gates.
You were there?
No.
Is that regret in your voice?
I did regret not dying there for many years, but no longer.
Oh! Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves.
Freya, here.
A dawn bloom. You have an interest in botanicals now?
Freya, returning to the story of your brother, you said he made it his mission to find the source of Bifrost light.
He did indeed.
Not now.
Another carving from Yari and Somer.
There's probably another ingredient around here, brother.
It is an ingredient from the recipe. How did they reach this realm?
Oh, they were well versed in realm travel. You see, Yari was raised a Midgardian warrior. Meant to fight in the family's wars. Find a wife. Aye for glory. But he rejected it. He left.
He followed his own path.
I wouldn't be surprised if we found their mark in other realms as well.
Gravestone. No doubt a berserker awaits.
Ah!
light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
Aye. Fair bet this is the sanctum Bigvir spoke of in Vanheim. Nicely done! Keep on it!
Close in! Attack!
So, which is your favorite of Gavassia's poems, brother?
Why would I choose a favorite?
Fuck!